the seven deadly sins. The seven deadly sins originated from Christianity and were used by the church as a means to stop people from doing evil, claiming that there would be dire consequences for anyone who committed any of the seven deadly sins. Let's go over them, shall we? The first deadly sin is lust. Lust is the disordered love for individuals, and also the least serious sin. In the book The Divine Comedy, souls who have committed the sins of lust are blown about in a never-ending hurricane-like winds, symbolic of their own lack of self-control through their lustful passions in life. The second deadly sin is gluttony. Gluttony is considered a sin if the excessive desire for food causes it to be withheld from the needy. Gluttony is selflessness, essentially placing concern with one's own impulses or interests above the well-being or interests of others. For example, eating all the bread in the world while other people are hungry. The third deadly sin is greed. Greed is a desire to acquire or possess more than one needs, especially with respect to material wealth. This sin leads to theft, violence, manipulation, and trickery. The fourth deadly sin is sloth. Sloth can mean many things, from being lazy to neglect one's task, or even to neglect their own body. Sloth has also been defined as a failure to do things that one should do. By this definition, evil exists when good people fail to act. You can't commit the sloth sin though, like the other sins, as the neglect of doing anything is considered a sin. The fifth deadly sin is wrath. Wrath can lead to anger, rage, and hatred. In the Divine Comedy, hell is divided in 9 circles. According to the author, this is what takes place in the circle of wrath. In the swampy, stinky waters of the River Styx, the fifth circle, the actively wrathful fight each other viciously on the surface of the slime, while the passively wrathful lie beneath the water, withdrawn into a black sulkiness, which can find no joy in God or man or the universe. At the surface of the full marsh, the active hatred rent and snarl at one another. At the bottom, the sullen hatred lie gurgling, unable to even express themselves for the rage that chokes them. The sixth sin is envy. Envy is similar to jealousy in that they both feel discontent towards someone's trait, status, abilities, or reward. Envy can be directly related to the Ten Commandments specifically. Neither shall you covet. Covet? Whatever, that's how you pronounce that. Anything that belongs to your neighbor. According to the Divine Comedy, a punishment for souls who have committed this sin will have their eyes sewed shut. In accordance with most widely accepted views, only pride weighs down the soul more than envy among the seven deadly sins. Just like pride, envy has been associated directly with the devil. And so we're at our seventh final sin, pride. Pride is the most serious of all seven deadly sins. Pride is identified as dangerously corrupt selfishness, the putting of one's own desire, urges, wants, and whims before the welfare of people. One of the better-known victims of pride is no one other than the angel Lucifer, whose pride filled him with so much evil that he forced a third of the other angels to worship him, causing him to fall from heaven and his transformation into Satan, or the devil. And that was the story of the seven deadly sins. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time. I really hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure to leave a like. Any suggestions are always welcome, and a subscribe to my channel would be greatly appreciated. Here is a random video on the left and a previous video on the right. Again, thanks for watching, and until next time.